Well, this is the final video in the first section of the class, and this video will be about Macaulay brackets, which I think will be a new topic for everybody. Okay, so the motivation for introducing these Macaulay brackets is that in some cases we want to consider functions that are discontinuous, or maybe their derivatives are discontinuous. And so the simplest example of a discontinuous function is what's shown here, the function that just jumps up from 0 to 1 when x crosses 0. So this function is equal to 0 for x less than or equal to 0 and equal to 1 for x greater than 0. This type of function might be used like if we were turning on a switch in an electrical signal. Something might jump from 0 to 1, or the voltage or whatever other quantity you're looking at. Or if you have two different materials, the material property of a bar might change abruptly when you go from one material to another. So this is examples of places that discontinuous functions might arise in applications, and we want to be able to model these things, and so we want to be able to use discontinuous functions like this one. And you could see maybe you could multiply this or add numbers to this function in order to build more complicated discontinuities. But this step function is kind of the most basic discontinuous function. And here's the graph of the step function, just to emphasize what it is. It jumps up from 0 to 1 when x crosses the y-axis. And so what is the integral of this? Maybe you would ask, right? We've been studying calculus in the last few videos. Well, the integral would be a function whose derivative is equal to the step function. And this ramp function, what's shown here, which goes from being 0 for x less than or equal to 0 to a simple ramp when x gets larger than 0, would have derivative equal to the step function everywhere, except for possibly at x equals 0. But you can just sort of ignore that one point where the derivatives wouldn't exist for the ramp function and say that the derivative of this ramp function is the step function. Here's the graph of the ramp function. And so we already see an example of the Macaulay bracket here. This is what we mean, these pointed brackets by Macaulay bracket. And so this bracket is a notation for the ramp function. And so the bracket simply indicates that we have whatever is inside the bracket when it's positive, and then 0 when the quantity inside the bracket x is less than or equal to 0. And so some basic examples of this would be the ramp function, perhaps, where the ramp starts rather than at x equals 0 at a different number, in this case x equals a. A is some other constant. And so we have a function that simply goes up with a ramp with slope 1 when x is greater than a and is simply 0 when x is less than a. The graph of this function, with the ramp starting at a, is shown here. So it simply is equal to 0 up to x equal a, and then is a ramp with slope 1, which is a linear line increasing with slope 1 when x is larger than a. Another example of using the Macaulay bracket notation would be this bracket squared. And so this function, when you simply square the one here, would be equal to x minus a squared when x is larger than a and 0 when x is less than a, and the graph would look like this. And one thing you could notice is that you can treat these using the same rules for differentiating polynomials as you normally would. So if you wanted to take the derivative of this x minus a Macaulay bracket squared, you would get 2 times this Macaulay bracket. And also you could do an integral of this Macaulay bracket, x minus a, would be 1 half the Macaulay bracket, x minus a squared over 2. Right. And we also introduce a Macaulay bracket notation for the step function. We just simply write this 0 as the exponent when we mean the step function. This has been a pretty quick introduction to Macaulay brackets, and I'm now going to give an example of using the Macaulay bracket notation in order to write a formula for a function Otherwise, this function, you'd have to write the formula using different parts, splitting up the definition of the function into the different regions where the definition changes. So when x is less than 0 in this case, when x is between 0 and 1, 1 and 2, and then when x is greater than 2. And using Macaulay brackets, we can write a simpler, shorter formula. And also, Macaulay brackets have another advantage that we can more easily calculate the integral of a function like this than if we wrote down a formula for the function using multipart notation. So let's look at this example. I'll do it by hand. Okay, so we have this function. It's not discontinuous, but it does change the slope abruptly, discontinuously, so the derivative is discontinuous at these places 0, 1, and 2. And so let's first write the formula for this function using the multipart notation, which I expect is probably how you would have done this in the past. So the multipart notation would go like this for this function. So we would have this function whose graph is shown, f of x, and when x is less than 0, the function is simply 0. So the value of f is 0 if x is less than or equal to 0. Then, when x is between 0 and 1, the function is just x. When x is between 1 and 2, well, here we have a line whose slope is negative 1, and the intercept up here would be at 2, and so it would be 2 minus x, if x is less than or equal to 1, and less than 2. These definitions actually agree at the endpoint, so it doesn't really matter how you set up these less than or equal to, or strict, these equalities, inequalities with the strict or non-strict inequalities. And then finally, for x larger than 2, it is again just 0. Okay, so this would be the multipart notation for this function. Now let's write the same function using the Macaulay bracket notation. So when you do this, write a function using Macaulay brackets, what you want to do is start from the left-hand side and then move to the right. And each time there is a change in the sort of discontinuity here in the derivative of the function, you introduce a new Macaulay bracket to accommodate that change. And so here you have f of x equals, all right, so the first discontinuity here is in the derivative is at x equals 0. And if we just only had that change in the derivative, and then it was this straight line afterwards, that would just be the regular ramp function. It's Macaulay bracket x, as I introduced. So this first Macaulay bracket gives us this change here. Okay, so now we continue to the right, and we get to the second place where the slope changes, and we need to introduce another Macaulay bracket at a equal 1 in order to accommodate this change. And the way you can do this for these functions which are lines is you can say, well, the slope between 0 and 1 is 1, and the slope between 1 and 2 is negative 1, so that means you have to subtract off 2 in order to get the right slope. So 2 times this Macaulay bracket starts at 1. And the reason we have 2 is that the slope now between 1 and 2 will be 1 minus 2 is negative 1. Okay, and then we get up to 2, and the slope changes, again, from negative 1, in between 1 and 2, to 0. And so we need to add this Macaulay bracket at 2 in order to give us that change. And so this would be the formula for the function using Macaulay brackets. Well, that obviously takes a fair bit less ink to write than the multipart notation. I would argue it's simpler as well. And one advantage is you can write the derivatives and integrals of this function fairly easily. So for example, if you want to take the derivative, The derivative is not so bad because we're using the multipart notation, because you could just differentiate each part, so you get 0, 1, negative 1. But you can also use the Macaulay bracket notation, so when you differentiate this ramp function, you get the step function. This is the notation using Macaulay brackets for that step function. When you differentiate this ramp function, Macaulay bracket x minus 1, you get the step function again, and the same for the last term. Okay, and if you can do a similar thing for integrating. If we integrate this function, do the indefinite integral, then you can integrate each of the terms. The integral of this Macaulay bracket can be Macaulay bracket x squared over 2 minus the integral of the second term would be x Macaulay bracket x1 squared, and it would be over 2, but that cancels with the 2 here, and then plus Macaulay bracket x minus 2 squared over 2. All right, and so this would be the indefinite integral, and since it's an indefinite integral, you should add a constant as well. And actually, this is more difficult to determine from the multipart formula. If you work out the formulas for this function on the right-hand side, in terms of the multipart formula, what you see is you get the integrals of each of the parts, but then there's also constants there. And those constants have been added in order to make this continuous. And the integral, the indefinite integral, has to be a continuous function. And if you simply integrate each of the parts separately, you won't get a continuous function. You have to add in the constants, which are different in each part. And so this is an advantage of the Macaulay bracket notation. That's the end of all the videos in the first section of the class on calculus. And in the next section, we're going to move on to discussing double integrals and line integrals in some calculus in more than one dimension.